I guess you wonder what I'm doing. I'm trying to illustrate to you, by a number of advertisements in this paper, that most of our news is extremely capitalistic. Look at this. You have one little story here and a huge advertisement underneath it. And you find this throughout every page of this newspaper and almost any newspaper in America. The interesting thing is that our friends, who are Zionists, in most part own these newspapers. And what they try to do in these papers is to tell us just how liberal they are and how they dislike capitalism. But as a matter of fact, these are the Rothschild bankers, each and every one of them, because these papers cost billions of dollars. In fact, this paper, the St. Louis Post-Dispatch, which was owned by the Jewish communist, founded by the Jewish communist, Joseph Pulitzer Sr., and his children throughout the ages, until a year or two ago they sold it. These papers were left-wing radical communist papers. But you see, it was nothing but a scam, because the Rothschild banks paid for these papers. That's where the Pulitzers got their money. They were connected with the Rothschilds by bloodline and by philosophy. The Rothschilds were a combination of communist and capitalist. They were capitalists in that they loaned their money to capitalists. They were communists in that they loaned their money to the Soviet Union and to any other communist party apparatus they could find. In fact, they started the Soviet Union. Well, you say, well, how is that? Well, look at this newspaper again. It's supposed to be liberal. It's supposed to be fighting for people and for their rights. But look at the ad on the back here. It has something to do with money. Let's see what to say here. It's your money, why pay to get it? And it's at nationalcity.com, whatever that is. At any rate, you get 3 extra hours of night calling using some sort of a deal. Here you have contests and things where they want you to buy something. They have things they want you to become interested in, like from Best Buy. And I'm not picking on Best Buy. It doesn't matter what it is. It's something capitalistic where someone buys the product for about 10 to 20 cents on the dollar and then sells it to you with a huge markup. This is the way that the system works. It's there to overcharge you, to make sure that the capitalist makes a lot of money. And the same thing happens in the Soviet Union, or it used to when the Soviet Union was there. Those folks had these dachas, which were little villas outside of town. They had cars, they had people to drive them around, and everyone else was standing in bread lines. This is the Zionist way, which is the communist way. And remember that Zionism is just the other side of the coin of communism. Heads, it's communism. Tails, it's capitalism. But in any case, the Rothschilds walk off with your money, and you're just out there alone. Now, one of the reasons I started telling you about this was that recently there was an article in the newspaper that the Pope had condemned both Marxism and communism. And it sounds kind of crazy. I mean, you ask yourself, well, what does communism and Marxism have in common? Well, they are both capitalist industries. They both are trying to win by having the largest number of production facilities in their country and then selling or distributing their products in a way that will further the government and its coffers, either through taxation or through some other mechanism. Now, what the Pope said was in Brazil, in a town called Aparecida, and the news article says in a major speech on Sunday, Benedict the 16th, the Pope, condemned capitalism and Marxism as systems designed to marginalize God. What do you think? Do you think that's true? They do marginalize God, there's no doubt about it. And he urged the Latin American clergy to feed people spiritual hunger as the way to ease poverty and halt the Roman Catholic Church's steady decline in the region. And according to the article, in speaking to Latin American bishops for a conference in the church's direction for the next decade, the Pope also condemned abortion and contraception and laws that permit them. Such laws, he said, are threatening the future of peoples. The speech was widely anticipated, and it just goes on. So at any rate, there you have it. The Pope is against communism and capitalism, and all for the same reason. They marginalize life, they marginalize people. How many times have you, as a person, spent hours and hours at work trying to make money and left your family or your girlfriend or your children alone so that you could earn more money? Probably, if you're like a lot of people, quite a few times. You're drawn by this desire to increase your wealth and also by your other desire to spend more time with your family. And that's one of the major conflicts in America today. And these are Zionist conflicts that are caused by the Zionist owners of the banks who have wheedled their way up to the top and then purchased just about every industry that there is in the United States. The general rule is this. A little guy, whether he's Zionist or not, starts a business, gets a patent, begins to build a business. Now, if the business becomes extremely successful, in comes the banker or the Zionist with money to loan that person, and eventually the person is so strapped with debt and with a desire to grow the company that he decides to sell portions of it through stock. And the people who have the money to purchase that stock are, guess who? The Zionists. And the reason it's the Zionists is because, well, they're bankers. They're the ones with the ability to print money for free from the U.S. Treasury. You and I can't do that, but a Zionist can do that if he owns a bank. All he has to do is approve a loan, fill out the form, send it up to the Federal Reserve. Federal Reserve passes it to the Treasury, and that amount of money is printed to cover that loan. As a result of this scheme, where they get money for free and you have to pay interest on your money, they've been able to control everything in the country that they want to control. And that means that they own these newspapers, and they've always owned these newspapers. And in these newspapers, they make even more money by advertising probably their own company. And in the little bit of copy that goes around the ad, they try to pretend that they're liberals. No, they're not liberals at all. That's just a scam. That is the shtick, the sell, the close. We're going to help you. We're going to protect you from the companies that want to exploit you. Well, what else can they do if they went up there and said, well, we're the companies that want to exploit you. We own these newspapers, and we're going to lie to you and tell you that we're going to help you to defeat these people so that you can have your life lived in a much better way. Well, they wouldn't sell very many papers. The shtick is capitalism against the worker. It's the good people against the bad people. The good people are the workers. The bad people are the capitalists. Well, these papers cost billions of dollars. These news studios cost billions of dollars. The TV stations cost billions of dollars. So who are these people kidding? These Zionists that own these stations and these newspapers are billionaires. And if they're not billionaires, well, they borrowed billions in order to own what they own. So they're not on your side. They're on the side of their advertisers. All those companies are trying to gouge you, which means the car companies, the banks, the utilities, the lawyers, the credit card companies, all these people are there trying to stab you in the back. They don't give you a credit card for nothing in order that you're going to have a better life. No, it's in the hope that eventually you're going to miss a payment and they'll be able to charge you $35. And if you miss five in a day, well, it's going to be closer to maybe $160 or $180. That's why they lure you in, so they can screw you over. I'm sorry to use that word, but that's basically what the word is. They want to cheat you, and they're waiting to pull that trigger at your bank the moment that you write a check for too much money or overuse your credit card. And that's just tough, isn't it?